Alrighty, so yeah, politically talking, the succession state, succeeding the United States. To succeed out of the United States, you have to really have a goal and a reason. This is a great opportune time, because oddly, Trump himself is a business motivated president, so he really doesn't care if your particular state stays within the United States, just as long as your particular state is as Syria is stating, and you will do business with the United States. Do you understand? That's really his motivation. So we can seize this moment and go, hey, great. Wash all of those things away. Take the military out of our state. Take it back. Bring it back to your federal ordinance, and we can be a peaceful state that becomes a country. Okay, so you can take California. You can join California and Oregon and Washington together, and that would be kind of a really cool union of group that could be peaceful. It would not have any war machines. It would not have any army. It would only have a policing jurisdiction, for wayward criminals as usual. But that would be like its own little country. Now, when I say a country that does not have an army, yes, because there are many countries all over the world that do not have armies. Okay, now, so we would just be following suit with those. And likewise, we should be treated similarly as those countries are. So we would not be, oh my goodness, free land. No, it doesn't go that way. What do we bring to the table? It's always that as well. What would we bring to the table? We can bring casinos. We can bring banking jurisdiction, different, that is superior to what the United States offers also. So when we start bringing into a better banking environment, we would become eye appealing to citizens of the normal United States of America. So they would actually want to go, we would be the Switzerland of the United States. So they would try to move their money over to California banks and go, wow, California banks, yes, I get a little bit of extra interest there. It's not something I have to write down on my taxations. I'm allowed to have 10,000 or whatever outside of the United States that is untaxable, blah, blah, blah. So all of these little cutesy things can start to happen. So in a way, we can be a little bit of a favorable banking country. So even Republicans would be, yeah, that's not a bad idea. That's just not a bad idea at all. Maybe we're tired of dealing with having money shifted overseas or whatever, or there or whatever. So yeah, right there in California, we would just, it would be like, pal, or our pal. A pal country that's right next to us. Canada has not really offered that to the United States, so they've lost out. And Mexico has not offered that. So yeah, we've not seen really heightened banking, favorative banking going on between so close, a close border. Okay, so yeah, so that would be one thing that I would definitely bring into the equation for success. Okay, so you have the banking institutions hyped up to be a better savings medium that isn't compared to the savings mediums in the United States. Okay, so when you secede, it's not a bad thing. I mean, we already have plenty of money, taxation wise, so we would be our own federal instead of, and that would be that. But and the rules are already there of how to run, essentially, the state itself. The rules are already there. We actually don't need the federal. The rules have been there a long, long time. The only thing would be other states. Are you going to include Oregon? Are you going to include Washington? So those types of of groupings. So it's a great moment, actually. It's a great moment. So we could actually be a partnership with the United States, however, a banking partnership, a country with the United States, and yet offer a peaceful community where there is no army, military, no weapons, none of that going on. And so we would be like, when I think of Moldova or something, when we would think of those types of countries that are all over the EU, they're in Africa or whatever. There's a lot of countries that are not hyped up into being a superpower. And so you're not hyped up in being a superpower, you're not really an attractive to another superpower. Do you understand what I'm saying? So if we make ourselves more attractive as a banking power, then all the world will be like, well, wait, maybe I need a California bank account now, you know. Instead of the Switzerland bank account, I need a California bank account. You know what I'm saying? So that would be not a bad upgrade. I don't know. So anyway, so it's feasible, and I'm talking now. I'm just trying to, like, let it enter into people's minds, you know, sift into there because it can actually happen. It's just I feel like right now we're just saddled with a huge amount of elders that are running this United States, and they're so old that I think, you know, the fashionable display of a succession is like, what? It's like a taboo, or they're too scared. So we have this problem with a lot of people that would be too scared. When I'm looking at the what do you call it, the political channels out there on the television, and I'm seeing the roundup of people, whoever they're doing, then in their Senate seats. I mean, they're just geriatric. Okay, and so unfortunately, you know, as life goes on with older people, they're scared to do things, they're scared to move, they're scared to change. And so this little gumption moment of a succeeding from, you know, being a peaceful country, finally, hey, there's just a bunch of peaceful people there. We're, you know, we've moved out all those military bases. That's it. It's just a peaceful place to go and visit. That's it, you know. And maybe put money in the bank and gamble sometimes. That would really be all we have to offer. You know, we would not be in this major competition with the United States. And I say competition, because you have to look at one country here and another country there. They're in a competition. We would not be in a competition with the friction of a military. We would not have, you know, this tit-for-tat action. You know, we would not have that going on. So in a way, we wouldn't be, what do you call it? We wouldn't be a hindrance to them. We wouldn't be a thorn in their side. We wouldn't be a worry. Be like, well, obviously, they're not going to ever attack us. You know, so we have, you know, they can just be settled. Oh, it's just a bunch of overdone liberals over there. You know, they can't even decide what liberal means. Okay, so let that happen, and then you can use us as a better medium for banking. You know, a fun savings set of countries. You know, I would love it to be California all the way up to Washington. I think that would be wonderful and great. And obviously, you know, because California is the breadbasket of so much agriculture, the trade would be the same as it always is. So actually, that would not be interrupted. The business trade with agriculture would be very similar, just as it is with Mexico and the United States. You know, it's a very, very similar set of business, so that actually wouldn't change. So we're trying to upgrade the business, So to upgrade the business in the United States, well, sometimes you have to be lucrative about where you put your savings. And that would we would be helping the others by becoming a very similar to a Switzerland or a Monaco. We would be helping very much so. Because, yeah, it's always something to look forward to, isn't it? It's something to look forward to. I'm like, oh my gosh, I get 8%. You understand? I get 8% in the California banking system. Isn't that cool? You know? So if you have that goal, you know, that's just an extra reason. This is an extra reason for your day. You know, when you're at work and you're having a tough day, you know, you're like, ugh, I've got a really good savings. You know what I'm saying? So it's an extra bonus. And a lot of Americans have not been able to take advantage of that. All right, so we have that. That would be a major, like, a bell ringer that would make us a wise choice. Maybe I'm saying bell ringer the wrong way. Yeah, but it will make us a wise choice, okay. And then also for the federal America, it's very happy to actually take back all of those weapons, to take back all of the military, and move it on to other soil. So in a way, we're reducing their military expenditures. They would be able to go zung, 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 you know, and actually clear out what they have and get the best of the best or whatever they want, you know. But it wouldn't be on our turf any longer, you understand. They can just go and cram it all into a pile over there in America and go, well, in the United States, and go, well, sift through it. Go, this was old, this is terrible, whatever. But, yeah, you know, so it's an opportunity to consolidate all that's been, you know, all that's in California, and just get rid of it and just move it over there into other states, Nevada and further all the way to Kentucky, I don't care. But yeah, just wherever you put your military items, just not in California any longer. And likewise, like I wrote on that previous one with the submarines and with the ships, they would have to be moved to ports. You'd have to, you know, take the trip around all the way to the east. If Washington is included, if Oregon is included in the seceding from the United States. Okay, so we have to look at this as a business venture also, and a really good one. It'll be a wonderful tourist place to go, be a very wonderful tourist industry, because when you are a peaceful group and you're not at this chance of a hyped up war, it's just like a different place to go visit. It's like going to visit Greece. I mean, you don't really think Greece is going to start pointing what do you call those, Luftwaffe, Waffas, or whatever, when you're on an island out there. It's never going to happen. It's just not going to happen. So you can just be silly and you can be on vacation. But the way America is now is it doesn't really have a vacation spot. Everything is just so pensive. It's like any moment, you know, we can just have global nuclear warfare break out. You know, so we would be the place where that would never be able to be possible. We would just be the peaceful place to visit. Peaceful California. Okay. And yeah, so anyway. Yeah, we are stricken with the name California. It's a long, terrible, laborious name for a country. I know that. But, that's the way it goes. And yikes. Yikes. I don't know. So it's either seize the day, seize the moment, carpe diem, everyone, or just be a bunch of geriatric old people like we see at the Senate floor, the House floor, talking today on a daily basis. Just, you know, continue with politics as that usual. You know, so those are the choices to make. It is funny, though, too, you know, this whole thing with, forget it. I'm changing the topic. I didn't want to change the topic. I just wanted to talk specifically about about the bonuses of succeeding these here United States. That's all.